meeting of the Board of Health. And first on our agenda are the acceptance of the minutes of the last meeting. Has everyone had a chance to read the minutes?
I just had two corrections. One is on the second page, second paragraph, three-fourths of the way down, starting with the sentence, moving forward with the appointment. And I'd like to strike out the word although and say despite having received assurances.
Say that again, please, Nancy.
What does the paragraph start with? Which
starts with moving forward. So this is the second page. So it would be moving forward.
Eighth sentence down there.
I'm sorry.
Doctor stated she had serious concerns in terms of the last resignation moving forward.
With the appointment, despite having received assurances. Just because it seems to make more grammatical sense. And then the other one was under that same paragraph, but I guess it's the third sentence down. Jean, you have her last name. Dalio stated probationary periods are not covered under personnel policies, followed by the sentence, Dan also said the Board of Health was not allowed to meet in executive session.
It says doctor was appointed to continue to serve as a member. You weren't appointed to be a member, but you were designated as a voting member, correct?
Because I am already a member.
Right.
So I guess you put down voting?
Voting member.
Mm-hmm. Yes, okay. Talia, I sent you a note regarding.
I got that, yes.
Did you list her as an associate in your minutes? She's still an associate.
Okay, so do I have to go back and I don't have to go all the way? I think just going forward.
I suppose if it's a big deal, yeah.
I mean, that goes back quite a ways.
How long have you been out of here?
Let's see. This is 2016. My second
2015.
15? Okay. Oh, that would be a ways back. Yeah, forward, I guess. If they haven't been posted online yet.
Oh, no, actually, I've only been associate since I stepped down to give you my full time
right,
spot.
So
that's right.
Last July.
That's right.
Right.
So it's been a year.
July.
Yep.
No.
Okay. Any changes? Okay.
That's all I had. Any motion to accept the minutes?
I make a motion to accept the minutes from June 21st.
Seconded? All in favor of approving the minutes?
Aye.
Aye. Mm-hmm. Any opposed? No. 3-0 approved minutes. My report, I just wanted to fill you in on our tobacco regulations. I did communicate with Maureen. She seems to be doing her last round of checks before our regulations go into effect on August 1st. She's done three rounds of checks. One was to first pass out the regulations. And the first were to handed out the notice of the hearing. The second was in April when she handed out the signed regulations. And the third was yesterday to make sure that everyone was aware of the regulations, which they seem to be.
Good.
Starting in August, she will be completing the usual round of inspections required by the state. They send a list of 25 of the community's retail stores every quarter. When she makes these, she will again check for flavored products. Her intentions are to issue any written warning for restricted products that she finds. If she then finds another issue subsequent to that, they will be fined.
Did she happen to mention, since we voted on these, have there been any change in violations?
Our violations?
That she has had in the town of Reading.
Not that I'm aware of.
Okay.
She did not mention anything.
She didn't mention. I was just curious if...
No. Okay. So that seems to be going well. August 1st is the date.
Good, good.
Next, I did send a letter to Speaker DeLeo.
Mm-hmm.
That has been sent. I've tried to reach out to the office as far as where that legislation is.
Mm-hmm.
Evidently, it is still in committee, in the Public Health Committee, a joint committee with Senate and House. DeLeo has not brought it to the floor yet, so I'm keeping an eye on that to see what goes on with that.
Is there anything more that we need to do? You've sent the letter.
I've sent the letter. He has to bring it to the floor. I believe Jason Lewis is the leader of the Public Health Committee. So
yes,
possibly we could try to influence him to see if he can get it moving.
Do you want to send him a letter from the board as an outreach? Or
we could do that, or I could actually just call him and see. I've been in communication with both
okay.
of their staff people, so we can do that. I can call to see what he thinks about it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
One thing on July 31st, we got a letter, I got an email from Laura regarding the mosquito and tick presentation at the library.
It's on July 31st.
July 31st.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna be away from that.
I have to work that evening, so if I get there, it would probably be after 9 o'clock.
Okay.
It starts at 8, so.
I'm going to actually be out for that.
You're going to be out.
What day of the week is that?
It's on Monday, I think.
Mm-hmm. I'm not sure.
I'll have to look.
Because I know
first
is a Tuesday. Okay.
Any other issues?
I do.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to have to be patient with me. I want to make sure I do everything by the book. So I did reach out to Cheryl Sabara. And she has made very clear suggestions in terms of her legal education. Just to be overly cautious, I also ran all of this by the DA's office. So what I'm asking the chair to do is to call for an executive session for the sole purpose of discussion of giving notice. Now, according to Cheryl, she has reviewed our charter. And while all personnel issues are handled by the town manager, we may go into executive session. The DA's office has also stated we qualify to go into executive session.
With notice.
There are 12 reasons you've got to
stipulate. There's 10 reasons. There's 10
reasons.
10
or 12, yeah.
There's 10. This is not an executive session to discuss the reason. It is an executive session for the sole purpose to discuss giving notice, which means we would be planning an executive session.
Okay.
So we are allowed to meet only to discuss that. Only to
discuss notice.
Notice.
Which Can I ask the context of this?
It's to actually plan it in terms of our schedules.
Oh.
And, exactly. And my understanding from the DA's office is we must have the tape turned off. We have to clear the room. Only the board members are allowed to stay. We have to take notes, and we have to have a roll call. And she has also outlined several other issues that we can get into farther down on the agenda.
Giving notice for what?
The agenda tonight.
Totally confused.
Okay. We may go into executive session purely for the purpose of discussing giving notice.
About what? Giving notice about what?
Giving notice, we can in fact plan. We qualify for the first reason for executive session, which is to discuss the reputation, character, physical condition, mental health, rather than professional competency of an individual, or to discuss the discipline or dismissal of or complaints or charges brought against public officer, employee, staff member, or individual. The individual to be discussed in such an executive session shall be notified in writing by the public body at least 48 hours prior to the proposed executive session, provided, however, that notification may be waived upon written agreement of the parties. Goes on and fully discusses all of that. We are not talking about item number one in our session.
No, but we would decide whether to meet about issue number two.
No, this is all number one. That everything I read to you is one of the 10 reasons why we may meet. And I'm going on.
But I'm just getting to, yeah. I'd like the reason that we would meet.
We would meet right now to actually plan when we're going to do that in terms of our schedules, mm-hmm. our vacation, availability of the board. Then we have to talk about, you have to, there's very clear guidelines that I've gotten of what you have to do as the chair for that.
To, you mean as far as notifying the person that we're due to discuss?
Yes.
Do we have to do a 48-hour notice to have the executive session?
Yes.
Okay. Any executive session.
This is different because nobody else is affected except the three of us.
Unless so we wouldn't have to give 48. We would have to
we
give 48
don't
hours.
Need to give each other. If we decide, the three of us decide mm-hmm. right now to waive that, mm-hmm. we may do that in order to plan this. Mm-hmm. Because it is not affecting anyone mm-hmm. else.
In order to plan going into executive session with,
yes, at a later
as
date.
As a later date to
yes.
discuss.
Yes, and I'm just getting this very clear because I want to make sure I have everything clear.
Did you run this by town council?
Excuse me, John.
Actually,
are you taking comments from
actually,
people other than board members?
This is what I am going by in terms of Cheryl Sabaro, who has read our town charter and through the DA's office in terms of what qualifies for an executive session.
I'm sorry, Andrew, what was the question?
Is this an open discussion or is it just
board members
right now?
No, it would just be once we choose to do this.
No, right now.
Right
are
now.
Are we having an open discussion or
well, I'm directing the chair. This is not open yet.
A little bit
we are just talking
okay,
about
or?
The board. No, the yeah, three of us are talking right now. But
okay.
the three of us are talking.
Yes.
This is a board issue.
Okay.
For the three of us.
Okay. So Dan and I shouldn't be chiming in right now.
Right.
No, that's
but that's
right.
Well,
that's
I think we
answer.
Have a lot to, we have
we,
something to discuss.
The three of us have something, yes.
So you're of the opinion that we should plan an executive session because of
information
the character of an employee.
This is, I'm going by the suggestion who basically strongly encouraged us to do that. In
and she's an attorney, correct?
Yes. And she has the same information that the three of us have.
Have there been charges brought against a public employee.
We are not discussing any of that right now. We cannot discuss any of that right now.
So we just have to agree to set up a time?
To meet as a board to talk about the purpose, for the sole purpose of discussion of giving notice.
Of future executive session.
That is all we are allowed to talk about.
So do we make a motion for that?
Well, we can direct the chair to do that, and he would make the motion.
Okay.
And he would have RCTV turn off.
Okay, and everybody leaves the room?
And we close the door.
Okay.
And you would direct everybody that we will be returning to open session. Sometimes people close a session, they don't come back. We are taking a very brief respite. And you would say we are coming back to open session.
Point of order. Was this on your agenda for tonight, this executive session?
It was, I would believe it would be on the health agent, which is on the
So I'm taking things out of order.
Well, generally you would stipulate that your agenda is an executive session.
I did not.
Just to notify the public.
I am going by what I have been given by the director of policy and law to do in our next Board of Health meeting.
So we do not have to give notice for?
We are not giving notice to anyone.
So we don't have to give notice for the executive session to give notice?
Yes.
We don't?
We are just meeting to discuss this. We are not notifying anyone.
Okay, and because it's only the three of us, we don't have to, there's no, if there was a third, fourth person that had to come in, we'd have to give them 48 hours notice for this particular one. For the next one, if we decide to do another one, then we have to.
It is for the sole purpose.
Of scheduling?
Yes.
I was just of the opinion that whenever we went into executive session, you had to notify that you were going into executive session.
We had to notify all the participants within 48 hours. And we could,
or
we could,
can wait.
Or we could say, okay, yeah, we want 48 hours to do this. Or the three of us can decide we will waive that notice. We will agree to do it now. We don't need 48 hours to have that meeting plan the executive session.
Right.
Once we have that meeting, if we decide, say we didn't waive it, we'd say, okay, we're giving notice now, in 48 hours we're going to meet, the three of us. 48 hours we meet, the three of us, at that time, then we say, okay, let's have this executive session, let's do it on August 1st. And then we put the notice out 48 hours before August 1st.
This is from the DEA's office. If a discussion topic is proposed after the meeting notice is posted, and it was not reasonably anticipated by the chair more than 48 hours before the meeting, the public body should update its posting to provide the public with as much notice as possible.
Yes.
Although the public party may consider a topic that was not listed in the meeting notice if it was not anticipated, the AG strongly encourages public bodies, you know, to postpone discussions and actions on topics that are controversial or may be of particular interest to the public if they were not listed in the meeting notice. I'm not sure if our schedule is of
public interest
or controversial.
It's just a scheduling question.
But I'm being very careful to make sure that the Board of Health follows all the regulations.
So would you like to make a motion that we go into executive session?
You have to make the motion.
I would make the motion to go in executive session to discuss our schedule.
Yes.
You need to stipulate the 1 out of 10 that you're calling the executive.
We're not doing 1 out of 10, we're just scheduling. So I second the motion.
And then you will then do this when we come out.
That's another motion.
No, Dan's right. This is to
stipulate the reason you're calling the executive session.
To discuss our schedule.
Right.
In the executive session.
That's 1 of the 10.
No, for the sole purpose.
Yes.
So we have to, and it will be pertaining to item number 1. You are right, but we are not discussing this. We are not going to discuss item 1.
Okay.
It is pertaining to item one. No, I understand this.
You're on thin ground.
Yeah.
I think this is their meeting. We should let them have it.
Yeah, just advising them as a liaison, but I would defer to the chair.
Liaison, we're just.
Yeah, I understand that.
We're just supposed to, you're just liaisons report back. We're not supposed to get too involved in their meeting, Dan, right?
Trying to keep them on a legal.
Don't worry about us.
But I'm really trying to abide by all of that also, Dan, which is why I've gone through, you know, the director of policy and the DA's office.
The motion was seconded?
Yes, I second.
Okay.
Okay, we should enter executive session. I guess we have to turn that off.
Should say you.
And we're gonna return.
We will return at the end of our session.
For open meeting. Session, open meeting, yes, okay. Okay.
Okay, yes, we're ready to reconvene?
Yes.
I thought I already did, but yes.
You went, the tape wasn't on.
Okay, gee, I'm not quite sure where to go from here. We are. You may continue.
Okay. The other issue that Cheryl asked us to do, which is going to be difficult, because according to our last meeting, Jean stated we are not allowed to appoint the health agent temporarily.
But that is not correct.
Jean said that the town does not allow that. So Cheryl's suggestion that we, and here's the other piece of that, her suggestion.
Well, I think she was speaking of, wasn't she speaking about the town hiring?
That we are not allowed to do that.
I seem to remember.
It was actually in the meeting minutes that.
Yeah, I seem to remember that we could not, she cannot hire temporarily. I don't know if she meant that we can't appoint temporarily.
That we, she said probationary periods are covered under personnel policies. This is meeting minutes from last, and she said we were not allowed to dictate that.
She was not allowed to temporarily hire.
We were not allowed to appoint.
I didn't understand that to be the case. When she's talking about hiring.
Doctor inquired if there was a probationary period allowed for the appointment to the board.
Appointment.
To the board. Delio stated probationary periods are covered under personnel policies, and she did not allow us to do that. We asked her that last session.
Okay, I thought she meant that she would not hire temporarily. I didn't take that to mean that we could not appoint temporarily, but.
That's what I asked, for appointment to the Board of Health, and she said no. There were no temporary appointments allowed. So, because that was the other recommendation.
I'm sorry, does she have the authority to do that, to tell us that?
I couldn't find anything in the charter about that.
Right, so she had no authority to tell us that.
I don't know that. What I do know, I can only tell you what I know from Cheryl Sabaro, and from what also clearly is in the email that we all got from you yesterday, from the town council, which basically says, the charter dictates that all personnel issues are handled by the town manager. And that the town manager can basically hire or not hire. We cannot do that.
We cannot hire, correct.
No, we can only appoint.
Correct. And authorize.
Yes. Now, because her suggestion, Cheryl's suggestion, was that we could, we could temporarily appoint the agent until which time the HR department concludes its investigation is the problem. Because according to Donna Pierce, no one from the town council, or HR has contacted her regarding the letter that you shared with HR and the town on June, I think it's the 18th. So we must, as a board, now direct the town to open an investigation into the public health nurses' allegations and concerns.
What's the letter? I don't know that letter.
the email letter that was sent to the board by our public health nurse that John shared on...
Is that the one that Beth shared? Beth, you emailed us.
We all got that.
Right, and so that was shared with somebody else?
You shared that with the town.
I asked an opinion of our liaison.
Yes.
If the town had instituted any procedures.
Yes.
Did Donna, so Donna did not reach out directly to anybody, except...
The town needs to reach out directly to Donna.
Well, that was my question, is why would the town have an issue if nothing was brought to the town?
Well, I can only tell you from my experience working with battered women, or child abuse, or elder abuse, when you have allegations, you must investigate.
And you're saying that that letter was...
Sufficient.
Sufficient, the letter that I sent to the town liaison was sufficient for an investigation.
And that is also according to the Director of Policy and Law. And in fact, directs the town and says that she assumes that this is being done. And so whether it is us, the Board of Health, the manager through HR, or someone else, needs to follow up. So we may, as a board, direct the town to follow up.
Mm-hmm. Is that something that we would decide in an open meeting, or is that something that we would go into
a
executive session?
That is something, nope, that the board can ask the town to do that. We, as a board, may ask the town to follow up on our public health nurses' concerns. And it would be a way of clearing a lot up.
Well, I have brought that up with the town manager.
Mm-hmm.
And it is the opinion of the town manager that there is nothing there. Mm-hmm. There is not.
Mm-hmm.
There was nothing in the letter that was of substance to start an investigation.
There was enough substance that two lawyers have weighed in very differently than the town manager. And so it would be nice to clear the air so, in your words, we could move forward.
Yes.
This is holding up a lot of what the board would like to do.
Mm-hmm. That is correct.
So it would be really good to move forward and let them do what they do. We're not looking to do that. That's not our purview. But we can direct them to follow up on those concerns.
Well, I will restate our case.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what's the process for the board to request an investigation?
We can ask the town.
We can ask the town.
We can ask the town. It's just a very simple...
And if they refuse, which they sounds like there was already one...
Well, that it has already been, I think, decided that there is no warrant for an investigation, no cause.
Can we over...
We can ask as a board. You can feel free to share Cheryl's email with the town council.
Or with the town manager.
She says town manager, town council, whoever.
Town clerk?
She didn't say town clerk. She says whether it's the Board of Health, manager through HR. She, in fact, her first sentence is, this is an issue for town council.
Mm-hmm. Well, okay.
Speaking of town council, the letter that you shared with me and Beth yesterday from town council, the three pages, I had a lawyer reduce this legal lease to me in terms of what it says. It basically says, we can vote not to delegate. We don't have to appoint. We may appoint anyone to give us our health reports temporarily, whether that's Bob Bracey, who is still our health agent. I think he's still on the town payroll.
I believe so, yes.
So he is, for all practical purposes, still our health agent.
Mm-hmm.
Until we say otherwise.
Or he does.
Or he said, he does. So if that is not the case, that if he's not on town payroll, our town inspector could be temporarily appointed by the board to give us our reports as our agent. No one can do anything without our authority.
Correct.
Right. So I'm assuming that you have all of the reports because Bob Bracy is our health agent.
I have not received a report since the last one that the board received.
So the concern is we have a health agent who is not giving us our reports.
So we are not able to do our job?
We are not able to do our job because our current health agent is not reporting to us.
Mm-hmm. That's a problem.
Well, the last meeting, he was not here. We did not receive a report from either Gene
but
or...
But Darlene can actually give us the reports.
I don't personally have a lot of information. I'm not getting a lot of information myself. I have received this past week a number of inspections that John Freilich has done. But I don't have a lot of information that
you
I
don't
can
get
give
the reports.
You.
You don't get all the... What happens to the reports when they come into the office?
They normally would go to the health agent and be reviewed. If there was an issue, it would be addressed. And then I get them. I make sure that they're put into LaserFiche and recorded and filed. Then I kind of have a little bit of background on... If someone calls, I know how to direct it to the next person. But I just received some this past week. Prior to that, I have very, very few items have come across my desk.
So the concern is for 2 months, the Board of Health has not been receiving any health reports.
I did speak briefly with Bob. He assured me that there was nothing of any emergency that required
us. But he's still not
us.
Giving us our reports.
But I have not had a report in over a month.
Right.
And
so
who's doing the public health nurse work?
That's what I was hoping to ask Jean tonight.
So no one has notified
me.
So
who's
that is a
public?
Real concern that we don't have any information that we can
do our job as a board of health.
Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed. We need a health agent. We have got a health agent, but
a health agent, so we need the reports from the health agent.
Mm-hmm.
And we need to know what is going on with the public health nurse, because those are reports that are really essential.
Yes, we do need those.
So you don't have any sense of where that is in terms of if they posted her position, what they've done?
I have not been informed of that at all yet. No.
Okay.
I will inquire, but I have not been informed.
Okay. So that's the other issue that I had wanted to ask, if the board could get then, I guess, from our health agent, all correspondence, emails that have occurred between the health agent, Laura, and town management.
Is that something that we have the authority to do? Is that like a freedom of information, or is that?
Laura is actually on record saying that she is going to be, I'm going to actually borrow from the selectmen, transparency, that she is reporting to everyone. So I can't imagine that there's anything that shouldn't be open to the board.
I don't know the answer to that either. We could inquire.
Mm-hmm.
As I said, I was uncomfortable requesting that information, just because I wasn't sure it was our purview to.
Everything is actually our purview. It is, in fact, because it has to do with the health department.
Well, but she is not our health agent, and...
She is our health inspector. She is a health inspector right now.
Okay.
And she does inspections.
Mm-hmm.
And I can't imagine what the problem would be is if we had asked Joni for information.
Okay. Email communication, not inspections, email communications.
Email communications between her and town management. And a list of her meetings with, the agendas. If we could have that 24 hours before our next meeting.
Which would be next, did we decide Tuesday?
Start open meeting.
Our executive sessions?
Right, we have to still talk about that.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And we, I mean, we're mandated by the state to make sure that those inspections are being done. So if we can't get the reports, we can't obey the law that we're mandated to obey. I mean, that's why we're...
Well, they are being done, it's just...
We don't have any proof of that. I mean, a short conversation is...
Kind of instruction.
Yeah, I mean, and the nursing issues too, and the camps, and it's distressing.
Yes, ma'am.
So, sorry to interrupt. Just on the staying out of legal troubled waters, the board, you are responsible to the state legally.
Mm-hmm.
I just remember this from being in your shoes. And not the selectmen, not the town manager, not anybody else, but you three are the lucky it's that have to obey or have to make sure that the all the state laws and regulations, and there are a lot more than I could ever get my head around, are being obeyed. So to stay out of legal deep water there, that's why we always got the the reports in. So
so that's a concern.
I have been assured that there was no emergency.
No, I understand, but that still is not sufficient. We still can't review them.
Mm-hmm.
We can't pass that. It's not, it's actually not Bob's position to do that, to say don't worry about it.
Mm-hmm.
He has to give us the information.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I would just reiterate with the not having a public health nurse and not having diseases reported is troubling, because that's one of our jobs as well.
It is.
Inspection, I mean, there's food inspection, and then there's
and we do have
disease.
To report, we would have to report that to the state also.
Right, so we don't know, I mean, is somebody getting those reports of I mean, Dawn at Pryor got the reports if somebody had a reportable disease. So who's getting those reports now, reportable diseases, and where are they going, and who's managing them? Are there people out there that, you know, it's troubling from a public health standpoint, from a human health.
Yep, no.
So I think, I don't know what the next step is, but something has to change. We can't keep going month after month without
getting our reports.
All right.
Since we do have an appointed health agent right now.
No, I agree.
Okay. And I guess there's, I have one other issue that may or may not be related to that. You know, you also have a bunch of other stuff on the agenda is, I inquired why there was a police officer sent to our last Board of Health meeting, the one who stood behind us.
Mm-hmm.
Did you get any answers to that?
According to the town manager, he wanted to make sure that everyone was safe.
And what was the threat to public safety?
That was not clear.
And did he tell you why no one in the board was notified of what was the possible threat for our safety?
No, he did not mention that.
That's distressing. Because if our public safety is at risk, we should know before we walk into a room.
Well, I believe there may have been a rumor that there were going to be a lot of people here.
And?
Armed people or people with white masks on?
This is an open meeting.
Correct.
Even more concerned.
Yeah.
That no one in the board was notified of what the threat was.
I didn't take it that seriously, but okay.
He stood behind me.
Me too.
Mm-hmm.
It was a little off-putting. Not that he was there, but that he needed to be there.
So I don't know what we can do as a board other than to follow up with the town manager about communication, because there seems to be a problem with communication.
Okay, I didn't think it was that. I didn't think that much of it, but we can do that.
Thank you.
I mean, it's the first meeting that I've been at in the years I've been on the board that there was a police officer here.
For our safety.
Hmm.
Right, other than to part of the discussion.
Not talking about food poisoning either.
Or rabies.
Yeah. Okay, that was my only other issue, John.
Okay. Let's see. Next, pesticide update.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I did send all our changes back to Jean to be reviewed by town council.
Mm-hmm. Were they as you asked? I hope I got them.
Yes,
yes,
thank
all.
You.
Okay.
Thank
okay.
you for doing all of that. We instituted all of the changes that we had spoken about.
Mm-hmm.
Save the one thing that I did discuss with our town manager regarding the town-owned land. The town manager, according to the
mm-hmm.
town regulations,
mm-hmm.
is responsible for town-owned land.
Yes, that's the tree lawn,
sidewalk.
In fact, we specified. It's not talking about the playgrounds or
right. The town council's issue was we have mm-hmm. no jurisdiction over town land. That's the jurisdiction of town manager,
mm-hmm.
which as a reasonable
mm-hmm.
health issue, I would think that we can claim some responsibility of that. However, I wanted
mm-hmm.
to
you had
inform,
said that you wanted to make sure that,
inform
mm-hmm.
that the
yes.
town manager did not have any issues with that. I sent our mm-hmm. revised regulations over to the town manager.
Mm-hmm.
He is in the process of reviewing them and
mm-hmm.
did not denote any problems with what we had,
okay.
but he wanted to read it first.
Okay. So do we have a timeline where we could in fact send that finalized copy to Public Works and then schedule an open meeting?
Well,
a public hearing.
We could probably send it off now because
mm-hmm.
I think that's my final, unless I hear
okay.
anything from
okay.
from Ray. That's our final draft.
Okay. Do we need to vote on them today to send them to? I mean,
I'm
I think
sure
we need.
I don't think we
voting.
Have to vote to send.
To make a motion to pass them as they stand.
I think don't we have to first have the public walk me through this? Don't we have to have a public hearing?
No.
I think we with the tobacco regulations we voted on the regulation. I think we did some preliminary vote, and then maybe we had a vote to have the public hearing. But there was some preliminary approval of the tobacco regulations. Do you remember that?
I think we just conferred and we came up with the final with the final regulations. Then we voted.
Right.
Then we did have the public hearing.
Okay. The reason why I'm hesitating.
The public hearing was to mm-hmm. see if there was any public that
right.
And
then we had a vote later on after that.
And then we did not vote on it the night of the public hearing.
Right.
Because
right.
we did take whatever the public.
Yes, that's what I remember.
Yeah. Okay.
So we don't do that yet.
We could vote on it the night of the public hearing
okay.
If there was no dissent or any.
Mm-hmm.
So we can send it out and schedule a public hearing.
Yes.
We can schedule
ASAP.
It first to Public Works to Jane.
Mm-hmm.
Because she did ask for the final copy.
Do you have her?
I'll
email?
Send you her email.
Okay.
I'll send it to you. I have it at home.
Okay.
I have it here. That's the only thing she requested is the final copy. And as I said, Bob, he had given it his blessings because of his own experience with cancer.
Now, do we have a new tree warden?
We don't anymore. I think the tree warden, if I remember correctly, was in charge of the cemetery. That was a slash position, and he has resigned.
I have not heard that.
Oh, okay. The cemetery?
I'm just not aware of it.
Okay. Yeah, I think Bob was in charge of cemeteries slash tree warden, so.
Correct.
Right.
And I think the new one, didn't he leave, or has he
That's
left already?
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I think he gave his notice.
Okay.
But Jane would be the one who would review that, or at least was the one who walked me through everything before.
What's the timeline for a public hearing? Like, what's the, I don't remember.
We could maybe think, if we don't get any problems from town council, we could do it in our August meeting.
Oh, okay.
If we, are we gonna meet in August?
Yeah, yep.
That's,
okay.
It'd be nice to.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, get it going.
Yeah,
before it starts snowing.
Okay. Thank you, John.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. That was on my list.
Okay.
Let's see. Okay, so we've pretty much had our discussion on the health agent.
Mm-hmm.
And you did read the communication from from town council.
Yep. And that is basically, town manager can hire and fire. But the town, we don't have to appoint.
Well, according to what the town council's opinion was the town manager can appoint, because it's not restricted in the town charter, that the town manager can appoint a health agent.
Yes, the appointee by the town manager will have a title, but no authority to act for the Board of Health. No Board of Health records can be given to a person without authority. So our town manager may go ahead and appoint, but that person has a title, but no authority.
Without us giving it to them.
Yes.
Which is what we have right now, pretty much.
So the town manager may, in fact, appoint, according to everything that is in town council's letter. He may do that.
Mm-hmm.
We are the ones who grant authority.
In the possibility that we lose our current health agent,
we may appoint. As I had mentioned earlier, we may appoint John to give us our reports. We can't do anything temporary because of what we were told about personnel restrictions.
I'd still like to get a clarification of that. I was...
I just there's too many appoints happening here.
I think
I know in our health regulations that the our own health regulations that we didn't write, but a previous board wrote, that we appoint our health agent who then acts for on our behalf for state stuff, right?
Correct.
But then there's also there's other meanings of the word appoint, like to hire somebody.
Well,
all I know is the Board of Health regs,
yes.
The Reading Board of Health
yes.
regs, and the appoint in that. I mean, but I'm getting...
The town manager can certainly give her this title.
Mm-hmm.
That is his privilege to do that.
As the hiring.
He
authority.
Does. He has
that...
all of that. Yes, that is not in disagreement. We totally agree that he may do that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But without us voting to give her authority to act on behalf of the Board of Health, she has the title only.
Okay.
According to his 3-page email.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Mm-hmm. So he may. That's the second to last paragraph. The charter authorizes the town manager to appoint an employee to work under the board, but to reserve to the board the authority to delegate its powers as described in Mass General Law. Blah, 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 blah.
Mm-hmm.
And also opine that we consider doing so.
Yes. And I have great reservations of doing so without all of those other issues resolved first. So we may go forward.
Okay.
It is not a good idea to go grocery shopping when you're hungry.
Right.
I've done that before.
Yes, we want to make sure.
Can I ask for clarification of your last statement?
Going grocery shopping?
No, the issues. Issues.
We can't discuss it.
Oh, that was your...
Yeah.
Any other discussion?
You go, finish your thing.
No.
It's completely off topic.
This is off topic too, so I'll go after you're off topic.
Okay, so this is just to open this up for work that we can do. Mm-hmm. There was a report by Arcasa. Did you see this report? About overdose deaths in Reading?
Oh, I did see that.
Yeah,
yes.
So the numbers were from December of 2000 till June of 2017, mm-hmm. I believe 80. Overdose deaths, 63
mm-hmm.
were opioid.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have the year by year, so we don't know the trend, but I know there was one a couple of weeks ago, a young
mm-hmm.
man.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like 2 weeks ago. Yeah.
25?
Yeah, so I think it would be really important for the board to try to take that on in some way, collaboratively, you know, not by ourselves, but I
mm-hmm.
think we could...
Even the police department.
Police department, the school committee,
mm-hmm.
The mental health people, the
mm-hmm.
library,
mm-hmm.
There's a lot of great, there's some great resources, and I think it'd be really helpful to get people together and even young people who are addicted, who know people that are addicted, I mean, get some kind of a thinking group or a task force or something to really try to think outside the box, because whatever we're doing now isn't working. If the trend is getting worse, which that's sort of the impression, but we need those year by year numbers.
Would you think of working with Arcasa at all?
Absolutely. Oh yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Yep. And but just broaden it a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. I mean, they have some great people and great resources, and they've done a lot of work. So, but I think we could add our expertise in. And,
mm-hmm.
I think that'll be our next. Once we get the pesticide regulations done, that
and
can
that
be
is in fact what I was going to.
Oh, great minds.
Because mm-hmm. one of the things that I think I had forwarded via could have been through Jean was the website of the Board of Health for the Marblehead when I was
mm-hmm.
contacting them
mm-hmm.
about the regs.
Mm-hmm.
It is their Board of Health website actually has a wonderful resource page.
Okay.
But one of the things that I just noticed on someone else's webpage was it gave really clear-cut Narcan directions
mm.
on the webpage, which might
wow.
be something we want to put on our webpage,
mm.
and
mm-hmm.
that's certainly something you have great expertise in.
Sure.
Mm. He's a good injector.
No, but I mean, it was really kind of like sort of a YouTube video. It was just really three steps.
Mm. And Gloucester has a really... unique program too.
Mm, they do.
Yeah.
The police department.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But this is
to draw them.
It's educational. We're limited because
yep.
we're a volunteer board, but
mm-hmm.
we can do a lot of making education and resources available on our webpage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've got sort of a CE that I've had to do too that may
mm-hmm.
have some beneficial
mm-hmm.
steps or whatever.
Right.
So
excellent.
Yeah. Okay.
And the injection I was referring to was the flu shot that John gave me as a pharmacist several years in a row. I didn't want anybody to think that he's...
You can inject Narcan, but it's easy with the spray.
Oh, is it a spray? I don't
yeah.
even... I mean, see, I would have no idea
mm-hmm.
how to do anything with it.
That's why it would be nice
yes.
to have it on the page.
God forbid I ever need to... Yeah.
So.
Good. Okay.
And now I guess we open discussion.
I'm sorry, but
open it up.
Any public comment at all, or the public?
Just stop me with the opiate overdoses.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of a showstopper.
Yeah. Mm. Maybe we could reach out too to Arcasa to see if we can get a year to year breakdown to see if what that trajectory.
Was that included in that? I saw the chart. I can't remember if it was just a conglomerate. Mm-hmm. But they did note that this was just for estimates only. Were there, didn't they? They said that
pretty,
this was.
I don't. I'm not sure.
I thought there was a note there that don't take this for a gospel, but okay. That there were estimates involved.
Because I don't want to duplicate their work.
No.
I don't want people branching out, duplicating. We should really just look at what can we provide in addition, and that would be helpful to get.
Yeah, I thought they said it was not for publication because it was sort of estimated. They didn't have documentation on it.
Yeah, they're gonna, when they have documentation, they're gonna finalize it. We discussed this at our selectman meeting.
Okay.
Briefly, that it's gonna come out in September, I think.
Okay.
Was the projection that they want to really sort of quality assurance, quality control the data, and Erica did a lot of work with that, you know, looking at death certificates. Okay. So I think it's gonna come out in September.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So maybe we can sort of target that.
Yeah, that's when, only a month and a half away.
I know, it seems like a long way away, but yeah.
Okay.
We can put that on the agenda for September, right?
Yes. As far as dates for next month, do you have any special?
Nope.
Wednesday, that was the third Wednesday, was it the 16th, I think?
The 16th, yes. It's fine with me. You gonna be around?
Yep.
You gonna be around, John?
Yes, I will be back from vacation.
So my understanding is if all goes according, then we
from
could
town council?
Publicly advertise that this is the public hearing.
If I get back in time from town council, that it passes muster with him.
With town manager?
Well, town council through town manager.
Okay, well, I think.
But, yes, both of them actually.
Right, okay.
Yes.
What's the lead time we need for a public hearing?
At least a week. To be public, to publish in the paper.
2 weeks. I mean, I don't think there's a hard and fast rule for you guys.
I think it's a courtesy more. It's not a requirement,
right.
But we do that.
Okay. So maybe we could ask the town manager and tell them we're shooting for whatever date is a week
the 16th.
From.
So
we'll say we need these comments back by
the 7th of August.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that would
because that
would.
We're planning a public meeting on the.
And then they, if I remember correctly, they're the ones who pass it on. I think June told us that for the tobacco reg, she takes care of that, or you take care of that, Darlene.
Pass it on for
publication to the newspapers.
Yeah,
you take care of that. Okay.
So that we can keep things moving and we don't lose another month.
Very good. Anything else?
I really want to go under this now.
Yeah, thanks.
No other public comment?
No other
okay.
Input? No, I guess we will adjourn our meeting.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.